Welcome back, and the election results are almost, I would say, crystallized. Congress is ahead, can form the government. We have 20 independents. BJP is at 84. Roughly, Congress is 90 plus. So by the logic of inviting a party, which is the constitutional norm, the single largest party will get the invite. It is a sweep in Chhattisgarh for the Congress. It's a sweep for Telangana. It's a massive sweep. It's a massive sweep in Telangana. Simple majority for Mizo National Front in Mizoram. The only state which continues to fluctuate is Madhya Pradesh. So the jury is out. Whether it's going to go the Gujarat way, whether it's going to go Karnataka way, one has to wait and see, because if it has to go to Karnataka way, the BSP plays a very important part. And if it goes the Gujarat way, then I would say that the BJP will have to get 5-6 more seats more. I'm joined by two former chief ministers, Ajit Jogi, former chief minister of Chhattisgarh, and Sheila Dikshit, former chief minister of Delhi. Thank you, both of you, for making time for Wion. My first question to Mr. Jogi. Mr. Jogi, results aren't very encouraging. Congress has swept the election. A leaderless party has swept the election.
You are correct. The results are there. But I am happy that I formed a new party, a regional party, only for the people of Chhattisgarh. And I have been able to establish that party. We are winning a number of seats. We are present in every constituency, and we are getting a good percentage of votes. So I have been able to establish a third party. That is my satisfaction.
But can you, you have been chief minister of the state. You have been associated with the Congress party for a long standing time. It lost leadership in 2013. What has made Congress come back like this? It's not even a simple majority. It's a complete sweep. In your analysis, what has happened there?
See, at the ground level, we were always feeling that there is anger against the BJP. People wanted to throw BJP out at any cost. And that is what has been expressed ultimately. When they wanted to throw BJP out, the only alternative before them was Congress, because my party was only 2 months old. We had got the symbol only 2 months ago. Our symbol was not known to everybody. This is there are inaccessible parts, Naxalite parts in our state. So I'm happy that in 2 months we have been able to establish a third party, a third front, which will remain forever. And now the fight in Chhattisgarh would always be triangular.
But you could have stayed in Congress. The party is back in power after 15
years. I didn't
years.
Want to stay in Congress. I wanted to. That is a fact. But why I formed the party? I wanted that there should be a regional party in Chhattisgarh, which should take care of the problems and aspirations of the people of Chhattisgarh. The resource-rich state that Chhattisgarh is, the richest state and inhabited by the poorest people, I wanted to remove this paradox through a regional party, because I am convinced that a national party cannot do it. National party has ruled us for so long, but we are still having 50% people below the poverty line.
You can ask questions. Mr. Jogi, you stay with me for 5 minutes. I have a question for Sheila Dikshit, also former chief minister, three-time chief minister of Delhi and a former union minister. Sheila ji, the Congress is the comeback kid, at least in Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh?
Rajasthan looks very dicey.
I'd be careful about Rajasthan.
Rajasthan looks very.
Sheila ji, can you hear me?
I can't hear. No.
Can you hear me, Sheila ji?
I can't hear you.
I think there's a bit of a problem with Sheila Dikshit. Mr. Jogi, there are a lot of questions for you. Dr. Pranjpe.
Yes, for those who have been observing your career, Mr. Jogi, there's much to admire. You're a fighter. After a terrible accident, you've come back and you're still in the thick of politics. So, you know, your grit and stamina, as well as you said, your vision of regionalism for the state is admirable. Now, my question has to do with coalition politics and BSP. In some ways, your party and you yourself have also stood for the, you know, underprivileged, the SC. How do you see the role of BSP, which is a national party fighting for the underprivileged, the so-called Bahujan, and you, and parties like you? Do you think you can come together? Do you see a bigger role for BSP in national politics now?
I do see a very big role for Mayawati ji. She has an all India presence. She has her supporters and followers and workers everywhere. And when the Mahagathbandhan is formed, I can't say who all will be there. I wish everyone is there against the BJP. And she will be a prominent person in that Mahagathbandhan, and perhaps she could be projected as the Prime Minister of India.
Daniel, you had a question?
Yes. Mr. Jogi, I have a very simple question for you. With the kind of fight that the Congress has given in these three states, particularly the Congress resurrection in Chhattisgarh, what do you think about Rahul Gandhi today?
Rahul Gandhi is the president of the party, and party has done well, so he gets the credit for that. If party had not done well, he would have been blamed for that. So being the president, he takes the credit.
You know, I think we have been, thank you, Mr. Jogi, you stay with me. We have been able to rectify the audio problem we had with Sheila Dikshit. Sheila Dikshit, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for making time for Wion. A pleasant surprise from three states?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you now.
I'm saying, is it a pleasant surprise from three states?
Yes, it's been a very pleasant... I wouldn't say it's a surprise because we expected it, but it's been very pleasant.
What made you know, states like Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh tick? Because you know, you were nowhere in the fight and suddenly you seem to have at least recovered the ground which was lost in 2014.
Yes, that's true. But that's part of the culture of Congress. And with Rahul's leadership, I think we have taken a big leap forward.
A question to her? Okay. My colleague Daniel has a question for you, Sheila ji.
Ma'am, good afternoon. Just like Delhi, after three terms, we are seeing Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh also going out of power. What is your take on this triple anti-incumbency?
What do you mean by anti-incumbency? There is always anti-incumbency. When a government has been in power for some time, there's bound to be some anti-incumbency. Depends on how big that anti-incumbency is. Are the people looking for a change or are they not? In these cases, the people did look for a change and they got the change.
Yes, Dr. Paranjpe.
Ma'am, my question is, are we back to a two-party fight for the Lok Sabha elections to come? Between the Congress and the BJP?
Of course we are. This is only a kind... Yes, the, you know, when you look at the, what has happened in the current elections which are going on right now, you will realize that we are well prepared for the next parliament elections.
Can I ask, I'd like to ask a question too, because in Delhi, the Aam Aadmi replace the Congress Party. Now, do you see in the future, as you develop, you say, a two-party system, do you see the Congress Party in Delhi replacing the Aam Aadmi and again becoming the preeminent party in Delhi?
Well, in Delhi, when the elections come, then we will let you know where we are going to come back. Because remember, the Congress won the Delhi election three times in succession.
Mm. Or is it because?
So it's not that we cannot come back.
Of you,
we will come back.
Is it because of you that they won?
No, I wouldn't. No, I wouldn't say it's not because of me. It's the work that the Congress Party did, and I implemented it. The policies of the Congress Party, which I implemented.
Or is it because of the fact, Sheila ji, there was a great debate in Congress Party, which raged for a lot of time, you know, senior leaders and junior leaders not cooperating with each other. Do you think that at least in these three states, senior leaders like Kamal Nath, Digvijay Singh, Jyotiradeepa Sindhya, Rahul Singh, Suresh Pachauri, they came together, Ashok Gehlot, Sachin Pilot and other leaders, they came together, and in Chhattisgarh Party did not have a leader, so the workers came together.
Yes.
Do you think that it's the coming together of that generation which has affected this result?
Yes, I agree. You know, there are differences always. Everywhere people can have differences, political differences and otherwise. But when the challenge comes right on you, then you all get together because you are going for a win. And when if you want to win, then you are together. And this is what the Congress does all the time.
Does it mainstream legitimizes and give that electoral legitimacy to Rahul Gandhi, Sheila ji?
Of course it does. Of course it gives much more than just electoral legitimacy. He's our president and we treat him as a president. And we find that today he's a very successful president. He has guided the party in the right direction.
François, do you have a question?
There's a hang assembly in Madhya Pradesh. Is there going to be a role for black money for buying MPs like there's been so many times before?
Horse trading.
Something called horse trading, yes.
I think this...
No. I think you're imagining things. No.
I have seen it with my own eyes.
And last question, Sheila, Daniel, make your point, then we...
Ma'am, the Mahagathbandhan is taking shape. Yesterday we saw a massive meeting of opposition parties, which was interestingly attended by Aam Aadmi Party also.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think the Congress has made up its mind on accommodating the Aam Aadmi Party in the Mahagathbandhan? Because it was a very interesting thing to see Kejriwal at the meeting.
Yes, it was good to see him there. And the Mahagathbandhan is a Mahagathbandhan for all those who are anti-BJP and its policies. That's all. So we got together. Sometimes, you know, what you have fought with as an enemy, political enemy, becomes a friend because the time requires that.
Ma'am, isn't it too weak? Ma'am, but isn't it too lame to have only a single plank, which is anti-BJP or anti-Modi? Because after that, all these disparate group.
What do you mean by it's too late?
No, I'm saying too lame. In the end, they all start fighting with themselves when they have no other plank and nothing else to come together except
Why are you assuming all that?
I'm asking.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but why are you assuming things? Why can't you assume that it'll be effective and that everybody is coming together for a purpose? And the purpose is not a bad purpose.
So what is the purpose? I think
to get rid of Modi is the only
absolutely
purpose.
Thank you, Sheila.
I'm afraid.
Yes.
One bit. We can all come together because our situation wants it. And we have acted as per the situation and as per our thinking. How can you doubt that?
Thank you, Sheila ji, for joining us. But I think the...